Happy Friday, Grizzlies. I'm Brody Meeks.
And happy Ribbon Week. I'm Danielle Weicker. Welcome to GNN News.
What a whirlwind of a week it's been as winter sports take off. This week, we'll have a cool college highlight video, along with some other informative information about River Glen's family members, our dogs. See some cool videos of people experiencing their lives through their natural high, and finally check out the core.
GNN News starts now.
We couldn't turn.
Took on the mats on Wednesday night, facing off against North. Hillside and East is this preseason match, so there is no determination of a winner. Here's a quick highlight from Wednesday night's match. To continue on track to success, we're going to share a college highlight from one of your future Capitol teachers. Here's a little insight on Pullman's Washington State.
All right, seniors, we know this is an important time for you as you start to decide on your futures and where you want to spend the years after Capitol High School. The best piece of advice that I can give you is to go visit the particular college or university that you are hoping to attend. The minute you step foot on campus, you'll learn one of two things. Either you can see yourself there or it's not a good fit for you. Me personally, when I first stepped foot on the campus of Washington State University in Pullman, Washington, I knew that was a place for me. I never would have known that until I made the journey there and again stepped foot on campus and checked it out, and it became one of the best decisions that I ever made in my life.
When I went to Pullman for the first time, I wanted to go there so badly. And then I thought, this might be out of my reach. I actually am a Capitol High graduate. I graduated in 2000, so I'm an Idaho kid. And thinking, paying out-of-state tuition, it's gonna be so difficult, but I really wanted to go to Washington State, same as Mr. Moore. Felt like home to me the second I was there. So I looked into scholarships, and they actually had a really great scholarship called the Cougar Academic Award, which helped to offset the costs of my out-of-state tuition. So it was a great experience for me. I graduated in 4 years and worked really hard, but had a ton of fun and loved every minute of my college experience.
When I got there, not knowing anybody, which all of you may be a little scared going to a big university, not knowing anybody or only having one friend. So have an open mind. The people that I met in the dorms my first year are my friends for life. They're the ones that are my close-knit group that would be there for me at a drop of a hat. So when you go there, like I said, join some clubs, you know, interact with as many people as you can, because you never know who your lifelong friends might be.
That's a pretty awesome campus, and as we look at where we want to go after high school and pursue degrees, what we're passionate about. Hopefully along the way, we're able to express ourselves by igniting our passions through or in finding our natural highs.
Thank you. What's your passion? What's your purpose? What will you choose to do with your time? Your gifts? Your life? How will you define yourself? Listen to the voice inside you. Bring passion to everything you do. Take the time to master your craft, perfecting some detail that most people won't even notice. Be extraordinary. Get better. Become stronger. Show yourself. Show everyone. Do what you love and find your natural high.
Take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
I did it all.
where I live. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up.
This last week was Ribbon Week, a week to celebrate drug and alcohol prevention. The goal of this week is to promote the abilities of looking into hobbies such as you saw on the previous video. A huge thanks to our administration and well as leadership for putting these on for our student body. River Glen, nothing says friendship like our pets. Here is an insight on our dogs at River Glen.
Hi, I'm Chloe, a ninth grader here at River Glen. My dog's name is Bernie. He is a Cocker Spaniel and Poodle mix. At home, he is just the sweetest. You'll just bring a bone up onto your lap and then go to sleep there. However, sometimes he can be really ferocious.
My name is Holland Story and I'm in eighth grade. My dog is Dino. He is a Shepherd Lab Great Pyrenees kind of thing. He was adopted with a few of his siblings, but we only took him because we only had room for one dog. He does this really funny thing. When you scratch under his eyes, he'll like scrunch up his face so that he's smiling, and it's adorable.
Hi, my name is Sam. I'm a ninth grader here at River Glen. My dog is a mutt named Twyla. She is 1 year old. She doesn't like me too much, except for when I come home. In that case, she'll snuggle up against me and sometimes bite me in the act of love.
As always, way to represent our school by doing kind and positive things. Here's this week's core card nominations.
Hello, I am here to announce Grizzly to the Core. This core card was nominated by Mrs. Goffner. And the student is Jaden Lakatos. She says, you have really stepped up during cooking labs. Keep up the good work. Good job, Jaden.
Hi, I'm Mr. Gellner. This core card is for Mandy Collette for encouragement. Mandy made a great connection from a reading we made to a discussion we were having in class. I think that when students do that and they offer up their original ideas, it's really encouraging for other people to take chances in a science that's super important. Great job, Mandy.
Hi, so I gave a core card to Jacob Blumberg because Jacob is a very polite young man who I have witnessed do the right thing over and over again. Great job, buddy.
I wrote this card for Michaela Cochran Pilato. She is so wonderful. She honestly deserves a core card every day because she comes in, she has a positive attitude, she works really hard, and she takes initiative to do things to help me in the classroom and also other students. And I really, really appreciate that. Thank you so much for your hard work, Michaela.
This is for the awesome Javon Chipman, who won for the core card for character. Javon shows character by being a leader in Mrs. LeBlay's class, and this is from Miss Unger, who nominated him. So congrats, Javon.
Okay, this core card is for Tristan Wadesworth. This Tristan handled a touchy situation with maturity, which is why Mr. Yi has given him core card for this week.
Today in history, in 1941, the first Civil Air Patrol is organized in the United States.
Quote of the day, 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do rather than by the ones you did do, Mark Twain. Have a great weekend, Grizzlies.
See you next week on GNN News. Take it.